allowed us to include her into our coordination center. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Also, supervise statistics in respect of the staff and activities. So I will speak from the viewpoint of requirements of the Health Ministry to the reporting of federal statistical observations. I'll try to focus on the assessment. Integrated assessment of the indicators of the activity and the results, performance, attainment or not attainment of target indicators. I will show the national project to you, and please note that under the project healthcare, as has been mentioned by Vladimir, the achievement of target indicators are related with personnel deficit. That is the most difficult objective of all entities of the Russian Federation, because calculation of the needs in personnel and the deficit of personnel and closing of deficit and provision of personnel is most complicated. So provision of medical organization with skilled professionals is one of the main trends of the Ministry of Health that is supervised monthly. All of you know that we have federal register of medical workers today, and analytical possibilities of the register make it possible to take into account the improval or non-improval of the situation, provided that into the register the specialist of the Human Resources Department add information on changes in the situation in the institution about enrollment or dismissal of the workers. All the trends of development of the national project are concentrated among men, among patients. So awareness of our population about the tasks formulated by the Health Ministry and the government is quite high, as well as the expectations of the patient to get assistance is also quite high. Please note that achievement of target indicators, I would divide them into two groups. The main thing is reducing the death rate, revealing of diseases at the first and second stage, and propagation of the disease. These are target indicators specific for the oncological service, but the main responsibility is the work of primary medical and sanitary care. These are the experts who supply the patients who have the risk of development of diseases or have a disease to the oncological service. Here from the activity of the service will affect annual lethality and 5-year survivability, which also affected the death rate. Nevertheless, I divided personnel into two parts, personnel for ensuring primary medical sanitary aid, and in those regions where the level of primary care is lower, expectation should be accompanied by control if there are no specialists or para-doctors, if there are no paramedicals, or he might be absent or come once a week. He won't be able to do anything during that time. We have outpatients, central hospitals without at all oncologists or with oncologists, but the completion at therapeutic areas is low, as well as general practitioners. Hence, the methodological offices, your medical institutions, should also take that into care, into attention. And you have to use field teams of doctors, and you have to plan field teams on the, and their visits on a constant basis. And the report forms will see these activities. Now we make amendments to the forms of reporting, and we'll write it down there. Further, We have target indicators that will be monitored based on the results of the year and specialized reporting form. These are simple tables. You can do it each month or once in a quarter and see how the indicators change. In addition to the official reporting form on target indicators, we have some forms where the activities will be reflected. That is forms 30, 47, 14, 14 days. These are the main forms characterizing changes in the network and personnel in each entity of the Russian Federation. So I ask you, quickly, as soon as your centers collect the annual reports, please note the network forms. It's Form 30 and Form 47 reflected based on the tables. But the tables show all the activities which you organized during 2019, and you will see yourself and you will record that it is present. When the report is handed over, the information will be compared with the operational information, and questions will be asked why there was a different position of the between the operational information and the report is in a different format, and you won't be able to change. So you have to use two forms, 30 and 47. As to the personnel, I would build the following chain. Yes, personnel provision is ahead of any project, and the analysis of personnel will run parallel or in front of all the target indicators of the specialized service. This is managed schedule, equipment, and territorial planning of the network within the subject, and employees for the primary medical sanitary care. So under the forms of federal observation, these positions will determine the rating, the place, and the performance in the first year, 2019. As to the personnel for the main projects, for the main trends of the national project, 2017 is the basic year, 2018 is intermediate prior to implementing the project of 2019. We can see that experts and colleges generally in the Russian Federation are increasing in number, similar to the primary medical sanitary care. There is a certain plus or increase. However, as to that increase, we can draw a conclusion. Yes, if we analyze the provision point, 65 doctors per 10,000 of the population, I mean the colleges, that is 3.2% higher than the indicator of 2017. The same is recorded for other project deviations are slight. We go to 2019, 1st of January 2019, and we state that in 2018 there were no losses in the Russian Federation. That's good. We see no losses in the results and performance. As to different regions, the regions are divided into several positions. We divide them into four classes. I have shown only two federal entities that have conditional high provision 0.8 per 10,000. I won't list them. And the federal entities that have a low provision, 0.4 oncologies or less per 10,000. Along with the lack of losses in personnel, we can see some federal entities where the oncologies are quite few. Thus, you understand that they will be taken into account by the healthcare ministry and other stakeholders. When these indicators are overlapping the disease rate and death rate in these entities. So the difference in provision of personnel in the Russian Federation is threefold between different federal entities. Another situation is based on provision of personnel. This is always assessed simultaneously with provision. There were no losses with provision of colleges in the Russian Federation. As to the completion with personnel, it reduced. How can it, why should it reach? There was a growth in the manning schedule. Only two values are taken into account, number of physical entities, doctors, and manning positions planned in the entity. Their relation shows the completeness. And if we open the centers of outpatient aid or offices, if we plan to solve the problems quickly, if we include it into the program. First, we have formed the manning schedule, having taken the order and the manning schedule. In 2019, we have to report that we have opened everything. And the personnel position, we have planned it, but we don't have just a queue. Will take you, will or will not take you. We have a deficit of experts. And if we receive the quotas for ordinators, the experts will be ready only in 2021, even if we show that need now. Thus, until 2021, we'll reduce artificially the completeness with personnel below the base level in 2018. So you have to be careful when you form the manning schedule at the end of the year. The manning schedule should not make it possible to be in that trap. That indicator is a trap that will change the assessment of project implementation. Many schedule and personnel, several position completeness with doctors and colleges, 66.4%, and some federal entities have low completion, less than 50%, 34.9, 36, and more than 80%. I'm not listing them, but as compared to provision and low completion, you can understand what federal entities will be focused on, and their needs will be tracked, which soon all the entities will receive a letter from the ministry to provide the data on the needs for the next 3 years, so it has to be taken into account. So two personnel indicators which we work on, provision with doctors and population, one indicator, and the second indicator, completeness with experts as the same doctors and the manning schedule, and the interaction between them should also be taken into account. The calculation of the needs, determination of the deficit, and planning of the needs to cover the deficit. Doctors can come to the system, and in absolute values, the indicator will be higher than the previous year, and we'll tell Irina Vladimir about it with pleasure. But at the same time, we'll have more population in the federal entity. The indicator of provision will be lower technically, and the reverse situation. We haven't done anything in 2019. We haven't enrolled a single expert, but the population decreased for the reason beyond our control. The target indicator will be high and will be great, and Irina Vladimir will praise us. And she says, so the needs for medical personnel that has to be counted, the program of state guarantees, where there are norms per resident, financial norms that will give it possibility to see the volumes when opening structural units of a polyclinic or hospital, the volume indicator should increase. If you do not enroll everyone on the 31st of December, we have enrolled them, but they haven't yet worked. So that trap was also found when we organized the national project, and then the procedures and the standards recommended norms for the personnel that should be correlated with implementation of the program of state guarantees. Please note that many schedule is a non and inflexible instrument approved once a year. Many schedule in the system of mandatory medical insurance and paid services is a current document. It is approved by the chief medical officer of the medical institution. That is his authority, and it affects the indicators of completion first and foremost. So the manning schedule is a mobile instrument that should move within 1 year, reflect all the organizational changes in the subject. If you have no time to open plan making changes to the main schedule later. If you have time, you have recorded the main schedule. We have provision 543N, provision on organization of primary medical and centria. We shouldn't forget about order 203. In addition to 950N on oncology profiles, we have order 322 for all federal entities. The request is now compiled, and order 73 that shows the methodology of calculation of the needs for the nurses. These are working orders. Ministry of Health will make amendments to Order 73, but till the end of the year, the entities should report to the Ministry of Health about the needs and to plan the needs for the next 3 years. You have to finish. I'm finishing. We shouldn't forget that we have some norms, labor norms and type labor norms. Time in oncology has been completed, and order on the load oncologies. We will work with 543, 915 order. And what else I would like to mention? Many schedules should be constantly amended, and we have to see it in the Federal Register of Medical Workers and medical organizations as we realize all the problems.